guys, it's Tally again. I'm here to do the second book flip through of the three that I had mentioned in my weekly update yesterday. And this particular book flip through is going to be the Decorative Cross Stitch book. It is by Maria Diaz. And if anybody's interested in the publishing information, get to it because the pages are stuck together. It is copyrighted 2003. It's actually from New Holland Publishers. So there's your table of contents. Sorry. Just for this particular video, I'm going to take this book jacket off just because it's kind of annoying. So, I mean, it's the same. With the book jacket on or not. So, they give an introduction, obviously. And then they give you kind of an introduction to materials and techniques. How to do cross stitch, basically. And then your first section is going to be fruit and flower motifs. First is going to be summer fruits. Got strawberries and cherries there. This book is actually like not just stitching stuff and framing it and calling it a day. And really not even like just cross stitch on a pillow and that's it. There are a few pillows in here, but it's more of like home decor type stitching thing, like projects you can do with that. And then we go again into, I'm going to try to do this without showing the pattern, the strawberry and the other on the towel. Yeah. And then we have Art Deco Rose Sewing Set. And yeah, that's 14 count, Ada. And then we have Red Poppies. They have framed it, but they also have it on a pillow here, like on the end of the pillow. Cushion cover, sorry. And then we have the Green Leaves Table Linen. So you have a tablecloth and a napkin and coaster. They didn't really have the coaster. They have the coaster, but it's like way off in the background. Sorry. Just one of the leaf designs. And we have Daisy Picnic Basket. Gonna have it on the cloth here. And then on a picnic basket cover. They do give you directions on how to make that picnic basket cover. Let me show this watch line. So there's your cover there, and they give the instructions on how to put it together. And then they have, I never know how to say this one, Camellia? Bed linen? Pillowcase, the actual bed sheet, and then as kind of a apothecary jar topper. And the next section is called Picture Motifs. Then we have the Seashell Bathroom. Very simple. And a lot of these, they are very simple designs. Something you could stitch up pretty quickly. Whether you're doing them on a linen or whatever they have suggested, where you're doing it that way or just stitching it up just to do something, that would be, they're very easy. And so that's the other thing, it's where you have the seashells on the bath towel. And then we have windmill pantry. Now, I can just skip ahead real quick, see what this dead lane thing is. Okay. I've never seen this type of thing before. This is a dish towel patch. This is on a dish towel. And then you have a shelf band. Again, something like this would actually be good on the bottom of a towel or something. And then here's that green linen tea set that was in the introduction picture. Gingham play mat and pram toys. Little play mat, the padded play mat for baby. There's a couple of different motifs on there. So you got a butterfly, house, little flower, and then you got little toy. And architectural drawing. There's that one. And then you've got this one down here too. Japanese lady. They've done this on a very open weave linen. See that? That's the only thing that bothers me about that. And that one, that right there is very pretty as well. That is very pretty. But that very, very open weave linen bothers me. But they've done it on a 28 count Quaker cloth. The next section is called animal designs, animal motifs. And so you have some black, just rooster, pig, duck, was it a sheep or a ram? And then you got cow. Then you have cute cat's breakfast set. Teddy bear baby set. Pet bib. They've got that done up on a toy. Like a bib on a toy. That middle design, it just says blanket patch. Possibly could be used as something like if you were to do a quilt with cross-stitched motifs in it. Something like that might work out. Bluebird bed linen. Put these down here. And then these are just on the corners of the pillow shams. The noise you hear in the background will be by two cats trying to get at each other. I have Dean shut up in the bedroom because I can't be bothered to babysit them right now. That box, yeah, that's a little trinket box. Why they would call it bed linen set. That's just a little trinket box right there. Seaside bathroom. They put these random patches on everything, I swear. You got fish, a couple of fish, seahorse. Next section is geometric motifs. Blue and white sampler. And they have kind of have another design here on the trinket box. And then another little something right here that I will show you in a second so you can get a better look at it. This is a notebook cover. They've done this on the notebook. That's what that is. Basically, it's the same design, but smaller. The original one that they've got hanging is just, it just says Ada. It just says Ada. Playing card motifs. This is cute. I like these. These would make, like, especially that, would make really good for a Valentine's Day card. Oh, yeah. Y'all see the band along the top there? That is, what is that? Yeah, that's the sheet. It's the sheet band. Then red and white table linen. Turkish bathroom. That's a really pretty design motifs as well. I could actually see myself doing that motif like that on some hand towels or something. And then they do give you in the back, that's the last of the patterns, but in, they do give you in the back a DMC chart. The DMC chart and colors, just like you would find in those color cards. And then finally, the anchor conversion chart. That's what I find the most interesting. They give you a DMC to anchor conversion chart. So that's going to be it for that book. So it does look like this. I mean, whether I put the jacket, the dust jacket back on it, or you may find it without the jacket. I'll just take it off for now. It looks like this. It's a cross stitch, decorative cross stitch by Maria Diaz from 2003. That's going to be it for this particular video. I have one more to do, and until next video, take care, guys.